Michelle Glass here, and we are back still looking at the cranial bones of the skull, and the bone that we're going to talk about today is the occipital bone, which is the bone at the very back here. The occipital bone, we want to make sure we're tracing it out using our suture lines. We're looking here, of course, at the external view. So you want to make sure that you can see your occipital bone from the internal view as well. Again, use those suture lines to help trace that out for yourself. Now, what I like to do with my occipital bone is to work on the posterior view here. And what I like to do is look for my upside down V and my suture line. We're going to call this suture line the lambdoid suture in the future. Now, what I like to do is to take my finger, bring it down from that upside down V, and go straight down the model. And when I do that, I can find this bump is the first interesting thing that I see. And this bump is called the external occipital protuberance. And the word protuberance here is just a fancy name for a bump. From the external occipital protuberance, I'm going to continue my finger down and I find this raised line in the bone. A raised line in the bone is called either a crest or margin. In this case, it's called a crest. So this is my external occipital crest. And then I'm going to move my finger straight down into this giant hole. Now this hole here is called the foramen magnum. The term foramen is used for any holes in the bone, typically allowing for the blood vessel or the nerve to penetrate through the bone. And in the case here, this is where the spinal cord meets up with the brain. So we're looking here at the foramen magnum. On either side of the foramen magnum here, you have these large projections. These are called external occipital condyles. Actually, the term external is not there. It's just occipital condyle. The occipital condyles are named because a condyle is a smooth, rounded, articular surface. And the term articular means attached together. So that's just a joint. So this is going to be where the skull is sitting on top of C1, which is the first vertebrae in the vertebral column. Now what I actually like to do next is to take my calvarium, take the top off of my skull, and then spin my model around so that I'm looking at it from this view. And then I'm going to take a paper clip and fit it through a passageway called hypoglossal canal. Now canals are different from foramen because canals are passageways, whereas a foramen is just a hole. So here's my hypoglossal canal. I have one on each side. See it here? I am finding it here from my external view, but you can see it also from the internal view here. So there and there. Now I like to be working from my external view and I like to find my occipital condyles, and then I like to stick my pointer in the hypoglossal canal, because then it makes it easier for me to find my next structure. This is difficult. The next structure I want to find here is the jugular foramen. Now notice the jugular foramen looks like it's two foramen that have been fused together. That's a pretty good viewpoint. Right here. Jugular foramen. There is an internal and external jugular coming down from the brain, and so that's why it looks like two foramen that have fused together. The jugular foramen is on that border between the occipital bone, which is the bone we're talking about, and our next bone that we will discuss, which is the temporal bone. You can see the jugular foramen from both the internal view, which is what we have here, and the external view, what we did a minute ago. So it's right there. Okay, so again, I found my occipital condyles. I stuck my pointer into hypoglossal canal, And then I can see kind of in a line my jugular foramen. Now this next passageway that I'm going to label is technically on the temporal bone, so that's the topic for our next video. But I like to name it here because I can see it in a straight line. So the next one that I'm going to name is right here. This is the carotid canal. The carotid canal, so it's a passageway for the carotid artery to go from the heart up toward the brain, basically. Now, on our models, we really only can see this from the external view. There's just one or two models that do go all the way through, but that's not typical. So this is how I like to test the carotid canal. Okay, and again, it's on the temporal bone, not the occipital bone. The only other structure to label on the occipital bone is in the internal view. We have an internal occipital protuberance and above that an internal occipital crest. And that's it. We can run through it again. Let's do that. So we have our whole occipital bone here. Use your suture line. Remember to trace out for yourself the whole occipital bone. Make sure you can see it from the internal view as well. Starting out by finding that lambdoid suture line, that upside down V, put your finger there. Finger there and bring it straight down. Find your external occipital protuberance, external occipital crest, foramen magnum. Put your fingers on the occipital condyles. Take off the calvarium if you like. Rotate the model around this direction. Get your pointer, stick it into the hypoglossal canal. Then find for yourself your jugular foramen. Boy, that's hard to show on the screen. And then your carotid canal here, which is on the temporal lobe. Oh, there we go. So there you can see jugular there. And then look at the internal view and find for yourself the internal occipital crest and the internal occipital protuberance.